Hi there. Good. How are you?
Good.
Good.
Nice to meet you.
You too.
So excited to chat with you. Reservation Dogs is like one of those shows that everybody's talking about, and I got to talk to the showrunner when I was at the SCAD TV Fest, so this is really exciting to talk with you too. So nice to meet you.
Awesome. You also. I'm so glad that we were able to make this work.
Yeah, me too. So at the start of season two, we find Elora headed to California with Jackie, and all of the res dogs are kind of doing their own thing. And I can't help but wonder, what does Jackie fulfill in a friendship that Elora's res dogs don't?
I think that in their friendship, that Jackie is somebody who's very much a go-getter. And I think that they're like, Elora and Jackie are really similar in the sense that they're both kind of like the leaders of their group of friends, that they're both people who are really ambitious and follow through on that plan. I think that Jackie is also somebody who Elora kind of looks up to and might be a little intimidated by, so is trying to like put on a cool front for. Yeah, I think there's lots of reasons why Jackie is somebody who's appealing for Elora.
Yeah, that makes sense. I was thinking about when going back through the season, thinking about the chase scene in episode two's run with you and Jackie and the hay bales. That was really intense. And I was wondering, what was it like filming that whole sequence?
It was so funny. We were like, are we shooting an episode of Reservation Dogs? Like, what's actually happening right now?
Right.
But like, one of the beautiful parts about Res Dogs is that it's like, we can be any genre. That like there's so much to our communities and to our stories that are genre bending, and I think that run was like a good example of that, of being like all of a sudden we're in like an action like chase sequence and seeing that, and it was really fun to film. But also Elva used to be like a track star. That's the actor who plays Jackie, and meanwhile I'm like running behind them with my little legs just like trying to keep up. I'm like 5 foot nothing,
That would be
just trying
me
to keep
too.
up.
That's so funny. But I was thinking also about the scene where, Megan Mullally is in that episode as Anna, which was such a weird, funny character. But Jackie catches Elora crying at Anna's in the middle of the night. And I was struck by that. Why is she having such an emotional response in that moment? Is it kind of all catching up to her at this point that, that she's away from home? And I wanted to hear your thoughts on that.
Oh, I think it's the combination of everything. Like, she's just left behind her community. She's left behind all of her friends. She's betrayed her best friend Bear. She feels guilty about that. She's having dreams about Daniel and these dreams that are really guilt-induced. Also, just like they were chased down by the, like, I think everything's just kind of accumulating and releasing, which is like, I don't know, about time. I'm like somebody who is definitely like not nearly as tough as Elora Dannon. And so it doesn't take me nearly as much to cry IRL as it would for Elora to finally break down in that moment.
Well, I also think it's funny how Jackie kind of just like shuts the door. It's like, okay, I'm not gonna, but I feel like Bear would have been there for her. Like Willie Jack would have been like, hey, what's going on? And it kind of shows the limitations of this friendship compared to her res
Yeah.
dogs. So yeah.
Yeah.
You co-wrote the episode Mabel, which might be my favorite episode of the season. I really
Thank
love
you.
that one. What was it like writing that episode, especially for your own character? I'm always fascinated when actors like write for themselves.
Yeah, I mean, I had no idea that I would even be writing for the season. Like, I feel very fortunate to have been invited into the writer's room. We're obviously all WGA members, we're all on strike, and I very much support that. And we're also the only all Indigenous writer's room in the industry
Wow.
for television in general. And so when I was approached to be a part of the writer's room, it was only supposed to be for a couple of weeks. It wasn't supposed to be for the entire time, let alone like being able to co-write with Sterlin. And it was intimidating. It was intimidating to have to write for Elora. I guess I had almost been like, give me cheese, give me like somebody else. But I know the character so thoroughly. And it was also just like really beautiful to be able to hand the reins off to Dana Scoulet, who I thought directed it just so beautifully. And it was like such an element of trust in there, of imagining this world and paying tribute to our communities and how we handle death, which I think is really special and really specific. It's very hands-on. Just the whole experience of that was just really, really special. And I don't know that I'll be able to experience anything like that again.
I think that's a really special episode too, because of the way the culture handles death, which is different from, I mean, I was thinking how like for Mabel to have her family surrounded by her, what a beautiful experience for them to be just like there by her side. I thought so many people don't have that. So I really appreciated seeing that. And special is the right word for it. It's a special episode.
Yeah.
I adore the final goodbye with her grandmother. And did how soon into the writing that episode did you know that Elora would be visited by the spirit of Mabel at the end of the episode?
I think we knew that right away. I think it was just not in the same vein of like William Knife Man as the spirit, but just like a last moment of Mabel being herself and getting to see her like thrive in her bingo best outfit and to be not this like angelic being, but being herself.
Yeah.
Which was something that we thought was really important. I think that was something that we had all considered from the very beginning. And there's something to it about Elora having experienced death in really tragic ways, with her mom being the first person she'd encountered death with, having passed from drunk driving when she was young, and then obviously being the person who found Daniel after he died by suicide. There's a lot of trauma around death for Elora specifically. And so in Mabel, really it was about letting go of someone in the right way, in the way that they're supposed to pass, surrounded by loved ones and community members, seeing them off as a spirit when they go. That I think was a really healing moment for Elora her journey.
Yeah. There's a moment at the end of decolonization. Thank you. Where Elora walks around her house and she thinks she hears voices singing from where her grandmother passed. And when she comes back to the couch, she like lets out a sigh. What does this moment mean to her related to the argument she had with Bear earlier? Like, is she afraid she's going to die alone? Even though her grandmother didn't die alone, but like, how does she, that moment seems to be very poignant.
I think that moment is more just like reflecting where Elora's at and realizing how her life has changed and that this home is her own and she's still reeling from the losses that she's experienced, but it's very much a new chapter for her. And knowing that she, even though she has her Riz Dogs fan, that she kind of is alone in the world, for better and for worse.
Yeah. Wow. Yeah. So the season ends with the group making it to California, which I feel like is like a culmination of the two seasons. What does this mean for the group going forward? Like, you know, what happened? What did you think of when you were filming it? Like, oh, wow. Like, this is kind of what this show has been building to.
Yeah, it was so beautiful to be able to do that. And there's so much more to the world of Reservation Dogs. There's so much more to our community. Filming it, it was like, it almost could have been a series finale if we wanted it to be.
Yeah, that's what I thought too. I'm like, is this over?
But there's still so much left. And so it's I think being able to have that beautiful moment of letting go of Daniel was so important for the characters, and also is letting them move past that and to obviously never forget, but to be able to move forward and figure out what life looks like through the grief. And I think that's something that we haven't necessarily had a chance to explore too much of in film and television. Season 3 is also especially beautiful, and I'm excited to be able to share it with everyone. I'm in Oklahoma right now filming.
Oh, that's great. Are you doing any more writing for this season too?
Yes, I was invited back into the writer's room this year.
That's awesome. That's great. Well, I can't wait to see what comes next. So yeah, thank you so much for your time. This was a great chat, great interview.
Oh my gosh, thank you so much.